The second speaker, and thank you very much, everyone. You are keeping the 5 minutes. Is Mouna Ghanem. Mouna is the head. Mouna does not need any introduction, I think. Mouna is an activist and an incredible activist, I must say. And she is the head of the Women Peace, the Syrian Women's Peace Platform. And she has also been a friend of Selwa. And Mouna, I would like you to take the floor.
Thank you very much, Hiba. Thank you, my colleagues. I would like to talk 3 points about this sad occasion. The first thing, that when I remember Selwa and I remember her personality, I think she represented everything wanted to be eliminated from the region. She was a beautiful, she was successful, she has a family, she believed in dignity, she believed in democracy. So by assassinating Selwa, there is a strong message that this values, these principles should be eliminated from the region. And if we look what happened in the region since the assassination of Selwa, we can see that most of these things are being fought against by many forces. Many political groups, they don't want the region to be a beautiful region. They don't want the region to be a democratic region. They don't want to be all these principles which Selwa represented. My second point, that since the assassination of Selwa, there has been a deterioration in the situation of the world regarding human rights and women rights in particular. And if we look what happens now, major countries are withdrawing from international organization. It's not that they are drawing from the international organization. They are weakening the international system which defend human rights, which protect human rights. I mean, if we look at the changes and the institution in the world, it is only, for example, WHO who cares about human rights. Now, there is other UN organization, but mainly WHO. And now WHO is very much weakened. UNICEF is very much weakened. And so many things happening. And I think this is a problem, because if measure the countries that are weakening this international organization, then there will not find any place to go to defend or to represent women's rights, because there will not have the right mechanism. I mean, we are talking about 1325, we are talking about CEDAW. This is all linked to the international United Nations setting, which was organized after the Second World War. And if this change, we are really in trouble. So we have to think about it. The other thing that for the whole region, starting from Iraq to Yemen to Syria, there is only militias increasing, you know, and there is very weak if there is any states, and the countries are being divided among this militias, not only among these militias, but also among other countries. And now the situation in Libya is like the situation in Syria. As a matter of fact, the situation in both countries is very much linked. Now they are negotiating the regional power, they are negotiating the future of Syria based on the future of Libya. And there is no ideas like states, there is no ideas like sovereignty, there is no ideas like rule of law, there is nothing for the people of the countries. It's only, and now if you look for the Syrian international peace process, the Syrians are not there. I mean, the other regional countries, they would meet, they would agree, and then they will, sometimes they inform the Syrians, sometimes they don't. So I think, and this is the same thing now, is starting in Libya, because there is a big event change with the clear intervention for some regional countries, and we are heading the same scenario. So, I mean, there is no hope in this region unless we come up again with the idea of state building. And this was my political agenda since I start to be very much involved in politics, that we need to have a strong states, because failure states is the source of all this jihadist and terrorism group, like Qaeda, like ISIS, like all of them. When we have a failure states, we don't have a future. We have only killing. We have only we have only blood. We have only radicalization. Now, my third point and my final point is that we want justice for all, but I think justice is not enough now. I mean, the only way I can see justice is by ensuring the change in the region, and the positive change which was wanted by Selwa. I mean, if we take two people to the jail, this is what will solve that. Maybe it will solve a personal emotion among the friends and among the family. But at the national level, at the political level, which Salwa was aspiring to, it's not enough to have this kind of justice. Justice is to be successful in making the right change by establishing a strong Libya, which has a rule of law, which has a woman rights, which has a future for the girls in education, in protection, in everything. And I think by working together, maybe we can have a hope, because as Susan has said, we are all losing hope. Thank you very much.